Dear colleagues, welcome to one of the most voluminous lectures of the entire course. The topic is the margin of the nodule, which is one of the most important signs. However, the inter-observer variation of this characteristic is the highest among suspicious features. This lecture serves as introduction to the chapter of nodule borders. So let's see the topics which will be discussed. First, I give an overview of some important considerations. Thereafter, I present the various forms of non-regular margins and try to place the importance of nodule borders in thyroids and in differential diagnostics of nodular goiter. I will shortly present the importance of this characteristic in different subtypes of thyroid carcinomas. We follow the presentation with the differential diagnostics of nodule margins. We discuss various forms of ill-defined and irregular borders. First, it should be noticed how a regular thyroid nodule looks like. It lasted more than 10 minutes to find nodules to demonstrate typical examples of normal borders. I had to surf on dozens of images because almost every nodule presents some irregularities. And this difficulty points out to one of the most important issues which will be discussed later. There is no exact definition on the normal and abnormal margins. Which degree of abnormality should be held as irregular? A normal nodule margin is characterized by sharp and smooth borders of its entire surface. It is to be avoided overrating small irregularities. The left nodule presents ill-defined parts in a small proportion of nodule margins, which does not reach an abnormal extent. The right hypercogenic nodule is not perfectly oval. Note the almost sharp small protrusion in the medial and in the lower part of the lesion. As a simple rule, the nodule border refers to the external surface of the lesion, more precisely, to the external surface of a single nodule. So external, single, and nodule. These features are the very essence. In the everyday practice, there are two situations in which we have to deal with internal borders of a nodule, in cystic and in heterogeneous nodules. The borders and the shape of the solid part of a mixed cystic solid nodule can have great relevance, but sharp protrusions in the surface of the solid part should not be interpreted as irregular margins because they are located internal. And similarly, the irregularities of the internal surface of a heterogeneous nodule should not be held as irregular nodule margins. The left images came from a mixed solid cystic nodule. Usually, as in this case, the solid part has irregular borders. The right case presents a heterogeneous nodule having econormal and deeply hypercogenic parts. There is a protrusion on the border between these areas, but again, this is not on the external surface of the lesion. It is more difficult and not infrequently impossible to resolve the next issue. Is a mass composed of multiple nodules, or the mass itself should be held as one nodule? As a rule, the margins are referred to a single nodule and not to that of a mass composed of multiple nodules. In the left upper image, the judgment is relatively easy. This mass is composed of multiple nodules, which makes the appearance of the surface of the entire mass undulated, similarly to an individual raspberry, which is made of numerous droplets. So the margins in the left upper case should not held as irregular. The situation is less evident in the left lower nodule. To analyze real-time videos is clearly superior to judgment on still images. The right upper case is a micronodular form of Hashimoto's thyroiditis. The surface of the mass is undulated, but this undulation does not mean irregular border because it is caused by the presence of multiple lesions next to each other. There is a mass composed of at least two nodules in the right lower image. The prominence in the dorsal part of the mass is in fact a separate nodule and not a pathological speculation or lobulation. And the third basic feature to fulfill the criteria of irregular border, margins are interpreted in the context of pathological nodules and not in the context of discrete equiabnormalities of Hashimoto's thyroiditis. This distinction leads to one of the most difficult issues in thyroidology, which will be discussed in a separate lecture. I present here two examples of Hashimoto's thyroiditis. Both cases present discrete hypoechogenic lesions, which is the most characteristic ultrasound presentation of this disease. These discrete lesions usually have abnormal borders. They might be speculated or lobulated, see here and there. Or the margins can be blurred, as demonstrated here and here. We have to bear in mind that only lobulated and speculated margins are encountered among irregular borders. Occasionally, the term infiltrative is also used for this subtype of abnormal nodule borders. Ill-defined or blurred borders are counted as abnormal, but not as irregular. The literature distinguishes between irregular and ill-defined borders because the former has a higher risk of malignancy than the latter. The left images demonstrate normal and abnormal but not irregular borders, while the right pictures do irregular margins. The upper presents lobulated, while the lower case does lobulated and speculated borders too. The real basis for irregular borders is the histologically perceived infiltrative growth of a lesion. On the other hand, it is very difficult to perform solid histological comparison in the event of nodule borders. One of the reasons of the highest inter-observer variation of nodule margins among suspicious ultrasound findings is that this characteristic is very exposed to technical issues. Part of these problems can be avoided, proper focusing and the change in settings from better resolution to better penetration are the clues. However, in obese patients or in large goiters, we cannot always prevent the technical problems. Another unavoidable issue is that it is not always possible to fit the probe all along to the neck of the patient. In nodules, which echogenicity is very similar or identical to the neighboring non-nodular tissue, the nodule borders can be also indistinctive. The medial part of the left nodule is blurred on transverse scan because of improper fitting of the transducer to the neck. On the other hand, on longitudinal section, the borders are sharp. It is not a coincidence. Simply because of the anatomy, the probe can be fit easier to the neck on longitudinal scan than on transverse section. In the right case, the lateral in the upper and the lower part in the lower image are not clearly demarcated. Note that there is a dark field which starts ventral to the thyroid because of improper fitting of the transducer. So in this case, the indistinctive margins are caused not by pathology, but by technical reasons. And as a final consideration, I only mention that the borders and shape of the nodule together with extrathyroidal spread belong to the same family of suspicious characteristics. Each of them refers to the infiltrative growth of a nodule.